Truth is heartfelt. Truth is felt by the heart, by your totality, by you, and not by your head. Remember, truth is felt by heart, by your totality, by you, but not by your head. Truth is, it simply is, and nothing can be said about it. The moment you try to say or assert, it becomes false. There is no need for any explanation. Unexplained, utterly immediate truth is. It surrounds you. It is within you, without you. There is no need to come to any conclusion about it. Truth is already concluded. You are in it. You cannot be without it. There is no way to lose it. There is no way to be distracted from it at all. You may be fast asleep, unaware, but still you are in it. But because of your sleep, you are not aware of it. So those who know truth know well that philosophy is not going to help in any way. The more you try to know about truth, the more you become asleep. The very effort to know leads you astray. Truth can be felt but cannot be known. When I say it can be felt, I mean you can be present to it and it can be present to it. You can be face to face with it. There is a possibility of a meeting. There is a possibility of becoming one with it. But there is no way to know it. This is the paradox of truth. You can be it, but there is no way to know it. Truth cannot be objectified. You cannot put it there and see it. You cannot hold it in your hand and see it. You cannot examine it from outside, only from inside. Only by becoming one with it, you can feel it. Feeling is the only knowledge possible. Hence, those who know say love alone is the way. Knowledge is a sort of ignorance. The word ignorance is very beautiful. Split it in two, it becomes ignorance. Truth cannot be ignored. That is what ignorance is otherwise. Truth is always present. Ignorance is nothing but ignoring the truth which is already there. And a man of knowledge becomes more and more ignorant. Because the more he thinks he knows, the more he becomes capable of ignoring that which is. And he goes on missing that which is. Lost in his theories, dogmas, creeds, scriptures, he no longer has any eye to look at the reality. Lost in the words, verbalizations, his vision is clouded. He cannot see that which is. The more you are clouded by your thinking, the more you are mind, the more you will be able to ignore the truth. Nothing like knowledge is needed, only innocence, a childlike innocence, vulnerable, open, yet not trying to know. In that very effort to know, there is violence. In that very effort to know, you have trespassed reality. In that very effort to know, you have become an onlooker. You have attacked reality and you are trying to rape reality. That is why I continuously say science is a rape on reality. The word science comes from a root which means to know. Science is knowledge. Religion is not knowledge. Religion is love. But the custodians of the outer religion has made it a knowledge. The word religion comes from a root which means binding together. Falling into love, becoming one, truth is felt. It is a lived and living experience. So whatsoever can be said about truth will not be true. Instead, it will be untrue. Just because it has been said, it becomes untrue. All that has been said up to now and all that will be said in future has nothing to do with truth. There is no way of expressing truth. Truth is very elusive. You cannot catch hold of it in words. You cannot catch hold of it through the mind. Mind goes on missing it because the very functioning of the mind is against truth. The functioning of mind is non-existential. It functions in that which is not, neither in the past nor in the future. It functions only in the past and the future, which are no more. The past is no more, the future is not yet, and the mind only functions either in the past or in the future. In the present, there is no mind. If you are here now, suddenly you have slipped out of mind. How can you think here now? Thinking will take you away from here now. A single thought and you are thousands of miles away from here now, from this very moment. In the here now, there is no possibility of any space for thinking to arise. Mind functions in the non-existent, in the fictitious and in the imaginary. Mind is a faculty of dreaming. It is a dream faculty. Truth is not known by mind. That is why I say it is not known at all. Truth is felt by the heart, by your totality, by you as an organic unity, not by your head. When you know truth, it overwhelms you. You know by the head and by the tongue. You know by your bones and to the very core of your existence. You know by your heart and by your blood. You know it by your breathing, just by your very being. Truth is known by being. That is the meaning when I say truth is felt. It is an experience. Experience of beyondness. Experience of totality. Experience of oneness. Experience of harmony. Experience of bliss.